You're the night, you're the color of my blood. You're the cure, you're the pain. You're the only thing I wanna touch. Never knew that it could mean so much. You can see the world you brought to life. To life. So love me like you do. La la, love me like you do. Love me like you do. La la, love me like you do. Touch me like you do. Ta ta, touch me like you do. What's up, everybody? So I decided to do my first ever room decor video, and I'm not gonna lie, it was not easy, but only because I was thinking about doing it for 2 months and it took like a month and a half to actually complete it. But I think they came out really cute, so I can't wait to get started. So let's just begin. The very first piece that I'm doing is actually this cotton candy that I googled from Google. Okay, that just sounded like totally weird, but I thought it add like a pop of color to my room, and I decided to use Sharpies, but again, you can use paint if you want to. And I put this on a canvas board. Again, you can use a post-it board if you're under budget. So next I put embellishment stickers that I got from Michael's. I just think it adds like more glamour to it, and I like a lot of glamour in my room, so I think it just completes it really well. And it was pretty easy to make and fun, and probably under 10 minutes to do.
We don't have to worry about nothing. Cause we got the fire and we burn in one hell of a something.
So I thought my room needs something cute, and I decided to make this little cotton candy kind of kawaii type of thing. And I got a bunch of cotton balls, and I got this little container from the dollar store. So I started pulling the cotton balls apart so that the cotton isn't so stuck together, and this is like the finished look once the cottons are pulled apart, which I probably don't need all of that. And I decided to put like a top on it. It kind of looks like this giant bird for some reason. And I got this like glossy paint. It's berry pink, because at the time when I went to Walmart, they did not have pastel pink, and I was like really sad. But you know, obviously the project has to be done, so I just decided to use berry pink instead. And I sprayed all over my white cotton, and try not to get this on your floor because I have like white floors and this is like really like not good. But I was really careful when I was doing this, so nothing got on my floor or my table. And then I just decided to put cute little eyes that I got from Michael's. I thought it just adds like a face to the actual cotton candy, and I thought it was really cute. And then I decided to add like a cute little nose and all that stuff.
I know that we are upside down, so hold your tongue and hear me out. I know that we were made to break, so what? I don't mind.
The next thing I did is this a little piece of decor that I got first, a block of for like fake plants. I think they're called foam blocks. I got this at Michael's, and then I also got this little piece of wood from Michael's as well, and it has the like word sweet on it, and I was like, oh, it's so cute. And then I got this from the dollar store. I just felt like the little balls kind of reminds me of candy, and they had like pink and yellow, and I just thought it was like really cute. So I decided to cut them. By the way, I use like regular scissors. Do not use regular scissors. Try to use like pliers. I didn't have pliers at a time, so it took me forever to cut these. So I placed about a few of these onto my foam block, and it's kind of like symbolizing like a garden or whatever. And then I decided to put extra little balls onto the foam block, and it kind of looks like they're falling from this like candy tree or whatever. And I just thought it was like really cute, and it adds like so much fun and color to my room. Yeah, don't mind me, I'm just having fun with my foam block room decor. So let's move on to the next project. Okay, so this is no first invention or whatever. I've seen this done so many times on YouTube, but I decided to print out cotton candy related pictures from Google, and then I had them printed from Walgreens, and then I added them to this yarn that I had. So then I added like little clips to it so that it would hold, and it's nothing new, but I just thought like it was so cute, so colorful, and so me, and it looked really good like in front of the curtains that I have on my bed. That it's our time, you and me bleed the same light. I want you to know. So now on to the main event of the night, which is what I was doing for several hours of my life. I was making pillowcases. I think I made a total of 7, but only kept 5 of them. Anyway, so I print out this cute little dinosaur holding cotton candy off of Google, and I decided to print it on transfer paper for white fabric, and I just cut out the white part as much as possible and flipped it over. By the way, if you have text, make sure you flip the text over in Word, but if you don't, then you can just, you know, iron on like as is. And then you peel it off slowly. Try not to go too fast because you don't want to peel the design off, and you want to wait like 10 minutes before you start peeling. So after that, I started going to make the back of the pillow, which are going to be like a slip cover kind of format. So I decided to fold over one a piece and iron it down, because I will be sewing this later. And then what I'm going to do is just take this to my sewing machine and start sewing it down. This again will be the back piece. Then I put the back piece together with the front piece and make sure all the ends are sewed up, and that's what it looks like. Then stuff my pillow, and there you go. You have this cute little dinosaur cotton candy pillow that you can lay on. Now the next one I did are pillowcases that are smaller than the dinosaur one. I actually made like 2 small pink ones, and I already sewed them up. So all I'm doing right now is decorating them. I got these puff balls from Michael's, and I just thought they like look like smaller versions of different colors of cotton candy. So I decided to just like go buck wild and started putting all of that in my pillowcase. And then I also stuffed the pillows and then flipped it over, and pretty much you have a very colorful pillow. By the way, I will use white pillow if you have it. I didn't have it at the time, so. And this is another design that I did. I hope you guys enjoyed that video, as it took me several days to complete, but I really like the outcome, and I hope you like this video as well. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up, follow me on my social media, and I will see you guys in the next video. You know we can.